So we're going to talk today about the parametric equations, and we're going to start with a reasonably familiar example. It's the unit circle, the circle that has radius 1 the whole way around and centre 0, 0. The Cartesian equation of that circle, as you would already know, is x squared plus y squared equals 1. Okay, and so that's familiar. What's not familiar is what are the parametric equations of that circle? Well, let me give you some background so that you know what's that even mean. Now, you'll know that anywhere on the circle, I could draw on any of the points around the circle, I could find a point x, y. There'd be an x ordinate and there'd be a y ordinate. Okay? And I want to bring in a third variable. We've got x, we've got y. The Cartesian equation only has x and y, and it relates them together in a single equation. But we're going to bring in another variable, because I think you'd agree, wherever I move that dot, there's always going to be an angle made with the x-axis there, right in that place there. Okay? And that's going to become the third variable that's going to allow me to make not one, but two equations, two parametric equations for this same circle. Let's draw in and make a right angle triangle there. I'll draw it over here as well. Now, think about that triangle. It's got a radius of 1, or it's got a hypotenuse of 1. It's got the angle down there. It's got an opposite side of the angle, which I'm going to call y because it's like the y coordinate. And it's got an adjacent side to the angle, which is we'll call x. So thinking about Sokotoa, we could come up with this equation. That sine theta equals the opposite side over the hypotenuse, therefore y equals sine theta. And so that distance is y, right? That distance is y. I can replace it with sine theta. So that distance is sine theta. Okay? And that actually is one of the parametric equations that we're going to come up with. So let's write that over here. The parametric equations of this circle. There's going to be two of them. We've actually done the second one first, and it's y equals sine theta. We now need an x parametric equation. Let's see that. And we come over here to the triangle, the same triangle as this triangle. We see that we've got our angle, and we've got the adjacent side and the hypotenuse. So cos theta equals x over 1. Therefore, x equals cos theta. So I can replace x with cos theta. Cos theta. Okay, and so now we know that the second parametric equation, well actually the first one, is x equals cos theta. So instead of one Cartesian equation with two variables, we've now got two parametric equations with one, two, three variables. And they are x, y, and theta. So they're going to relate together. And believe it or not, this is the hard part to get your head around. That represents exactly the same thing as that Cartesian equation, and I'll show you how in a few moments. Before I do that, focus back on this triangle. Now it's got a hypotenuse of 1, and it's got shorter sides cos and sine. Therefore, the sum of the two shorter sides, cos squared theta, that's the square of cos, plus sine squared theta, is equal to the square of the hypotenuse, which is 1. That's called the Pythagorean identity, and you're going to use that a whole lot in the rest of your mathematical career, wherever you go, the rest of your 11 and 12 into university. That's a big one, okay? So we'll continue this lesson in a moment.